Let us illustrate multicollinearity through the following example. Assume we want to determine the percentage of body fat. This is very difficult to do exactly and also expensive. So it would be better if we have a model that can predict the body fat percentage based on some easy measurable predictors. The predictors that we will take into account are the thickness of the triceps skin fold, the circumference of the thigh, and the circumference of the midarm. Biologically speaking, we would expect that all three of them are positively correlated with the body fat. So if your thigh is more wide, if the circumference is larger, then there will be more body fat, normally speaking. So we took measurements for 20 healthy women between the ages of 25 and 34, and we constructed a model. The model here gives us the following predictor. So we have a predictor of 4.3 for the first one, so for the tricep skin fold. We have a predictor of minus 2.8 for the thigh circumference and minus 2.1 for the midarm circumference. This already gives us a first indication that there might be a problem, because we said the circumference of thigh and midarm, we expect it to be large with larger percentages of body fat, so we expected a positive influence and not a negative. So here we already have an indication that there might be something wrong. Furthermore, what we see is that not a single predictor is significant. So all of them are larger than 10%. So based on this, we would not include a single of these predictors into the model, which also seems strange, especially if we look at the p-value of the model. So the p-value of the model just tells us whether or not the model itself is significant. And so here it says the model is significant because my p-value is extremely small. And if the model is significant, I would expect that at least one of the predictors also would be significant, and they are not. So we have a problem here, and this problem will be due to multicollinearity. So if we make a scatterplot matrix of the three predictors, what we see is that there here is a very strong, or there seems to be a very strong correlation between the skin fold, the triceps skin fold, and the thigh circumference. What can we do to solve it? Well, not too much, because they are not higher order terms, so we cannot center them. So we have to rely on other methods. What we first will do is we will look at the VIF. If we look at the VIF, we see that the VIF for the tricep skin fold is 708, for the thigh circumference is 564, and for the midarm circumference is 104. So basically, what we here see is that all three of them are over 100. Which proves again that the scatterplot matrix will not detect everything, because according to this, there is also multicollinearity with the midarm circumference, which we did not find, or which we could not pick up from the scatterplot matrix. So here we see that all three of them are high. There is multicollinearity with all three of them. The average VIF is even 460. So it means that my variance is inflated 460 times with respect to the variance that we would get if there was no correlation between the predictors. And the problem is, how can we correct it? Because they are, I said before, because they are not higher order terms, we cannot use the centering option, because it won't help at all. What we can do is we can combine predictors. We can combine them through, for example, principal component regression or other combination methods. So we get derivatives of the predictors, so we get sums or subtractions or whatever, linear combinations of the predictors. We could look for other types of regression, such as rich regression, but we cannot center them. So in this case, if we want to solve multicollinearity, we will have to rely on other methods, and most likely other regression methods, to get a good idea of the model. One final remark, a lot of textbooks advise to remove predictors from the model if there is multicollinearity. So they say if there is multicollinearity, just throw them out. However, multicollinearity can also indicate a strong confounding, and so it's better not to throw them out, but to rely on more advanced techniques and other techniques of regression.